to Yogaxpress, the mobile stretch clinic that takes yoga to the people. Yesterday, we talked about how we can stretch just staying seated in our chairs. And today, as a live example, Paul Chipkin is here with us, and he is going to stretch right where he is. We're all going to join him in a few moments. And Paul is a typical example of how we would be at our workplace. We'd be sitting in a chair, very relaxed, in regular work clothes, with our shoes on. Paul is going to manage to do these stretches even with his shoes on. You're going to see what he's going to do. So Paul Chipkin, thank you for being with us on the show. Paul is a producer at MNN. He has a program called Psyche in the Light, channel 57.
5784, and you said 35.
RCN 35. Josiane Hurd is a dancer, used to be a dancer by profession, and she has been practicing yoga as long as she can remember, for a very long time. Tony Taylor. Tony, if I get it wrong this time, please correct me. Tony has trained in film direction and acting, is that correct?
I have a degree in film.
One of these days I'll get it right, yes. Tony. Tony has been with us on several episodes as well. Jamie Avery. Has also practiced, did I say your name right?
That's right, it's Jamie Avery, yeah. I've been practicing yoga since I was a kid, 12 years old.
Right, so Jamie's been practicing yoga for a long time as well, and she's a bit of a yoga addict, she's still here. Thank you for coming here and stretching with us. Ginger Merritt has just finished her teacher training in yoga, and she's also an office manager. Can you folks see Ginger? Can you get Ginger on camera? Okay, good. And we have our special guest today, Khalebo Harris. Khalebo has this wonderful conference in Kerhonkson, upstate New York, on October 30th. Those of you who'd like to stay in touch with her, her email is going to come on the screen in just a moment. It's simply info@omoobatalaegbe.org. So stay in touch with Khalebo. She has this wonderful conference called Rebirthing Your Spirit. It's a 13th annual International Orisha Conference. By the time we get into this program tomorrow, I'll get that right. Orisha Conference on Friday, starting Friday, October 29th to Sunday, October 31st. So if you want more details, contact Khalebo. Khalebo, before we go into our stretches, we had just a couple of small questions. Actually, before we go into your questions, a little commercial for us. Those of you who want a copy of this free postcard, we practice these stretches. Our stretches here in this program, Yoga Express, are based on a simple ailment-specific sequence called 48 Plus. So if you want a copy of the postcard, we will send it to you. Just write to us through my website, www.yogaexpress.com. I'll also send you a fridge magnet and a card with a sequence on the back. So no escape. Stick this up on your fridge. You have this in your wallet, and you have this postcard in your bag. So no excuses and no reasons not to stretch. I will, if you're very good and you've been practicing regularly, I'll also send you a free copy of Yoga Secrets. It has 10 ailment-specific cards inside, which will help you stay with your practice. Khalebo, I had a couple of questions for you before we started stretching. I like that. You look so relaxed. I'm going to do that. Do you want... Folks at home, if you decide, we're going to do some chair stretches. This is workplace yoga. We're going to help you understand how easy it is to stretch right where you are at your workplace. Folks who find they're limited in their mobility, if you're in a wheelchair, please don't get discouraged. If you can move, you can stretch. And if we travel a lot, people like me who travel all the way to India, it takes me 19 hours. I'm not going to be sitting in my seat for 19 hours. I need to move around. But even where I am, if I am sitting in my seat, I can still stretch the upper part of my body. So, Khalebo, you did tell us last time what the term follow the elephants implied, but I had one more question. Would the practices that you have at the workshops that you have at your conference, how do you think that would help the well-being of those who participate over there? I know there's a certified dance therapist who's going to come there. There's a gong energy therapist. There's a program on Africa healing from the inside out. And there's a program about being in alignment with destiny and purpose. I love that name. And there's a program called Yoga Express. I'm going to be there as well. Those of you who'd like to come stretch with me and with the group who's going to be there with us, please come over. How do you think it's going to improve the well-being of the participants? I can see it on the surface, but could you tell us a little more?
I just think that people are going to have the opportunity to kind of stretch themselves. I don't mean stretching like a dancer, but stretch like this is rebirthing your spirit. So you kind of reconsider, well, do I like yoga? Oh, I like yoga. Oh, I like it a lot. You know, oh, do I like meditation? I like it a lot. I want it to be, we're looking at it as something that will help people to kind of open.
So basically raising an awareness.
Absolutely.
A self-awareness. And that's very important for all of us. We all need to be aware of our limits. We all need to be aware of our, you know, our body may stretch in different postures to at different depths each day. Every day our body is different. We all need to be aware of our strengths too. We all need to know that we are good in certain postures, not just postures, even in real life, but yoga will relate to our real life activities as well. So thank you. That you're right. It is a question of raising self-awareness. So I think we basically answered the question ourselves just talking through it. What about first-timers? People who are coming to this conference for the first time, what can they expect to learn?
How much fun the conference is, and how much organic things you can learn.
Right.
So you learn something at the conference, and then you decide to take it home and do it at home. So you get the handout from the conference, and you do the exercise at the conference, and you go, oh, I can do this at home. It only takes 5 minutes.
Right.
And out of that 5 minutes, you kind of reboot yourself.
Right.
We actually have a workshop called Reboot Your Box.
But that's not on your list yet.
Not yet. I have to add it. Our list is growing, but even that gives us this opportunity to think, well, what's different? What can I do different?
Right.
It gives you a chance to kind of look at, like you said, your strengths and then go, hey,
I can even do this. Yeah.
I can even do that. So we're kind of blossoming the strengths that you already have, and we're happy you have them, and we have them, and we're great with it.
Just enhance. That's
totally
wonderful.
Great.
That's wonderful. I'm really looking forward to that conference, and I hope some of you can make it. I hope some of our viewers can make it to the conference. You are going to have a lot of fun. I think that's the theme of the whole conference, right? Mm-hmm. Having fun, building self-awareness. We have one more question, but we'll get into that. Today we're going to continue to stretch. I want folks at home to recognize that you don't have to give up what you're doing. When you follow us in this program, you continue to do what you're doing. Yoga is not a substitute for anything else. It is in addition to. In fact, I think we should change the term alternative therapy. It should be called complementary therapy. Do you agree, Ginger?
Sure.
It should be side by side with everything, right?
It really should be. I mean, it's a great way to release tension, anxiety. I mean, side by side with talk therapy, understanding yourself, talking things through.
You shouldn't have to give up anything. It shouldn't be an alternative. It should be in addition to. So if you're seeing a doctor, please continue to see your doctor. Don't disappoint them. If you're going to the yoga schools, please keep going. This is supposed to be a link in your chain of fitness practice. We are just a very small link, but a very important link. So stay with us. We're all going to get on our chairs and get into a few more stretches today. We're hoping to cover about seven more stretches. Where did we stop last time? Was it Uttitapa, the number 13? So if anyone wants to bring their postcards next to them, we're going to get into Garudasana. I can already see through the side of my eye, Ginger's mind is working overtime. She knows exactly how we're going to get into this posture, right? Garuda is eagle. And for this, we can actually use both our legs. We can stretch both our legs and our arms at the same time, even though we're seated on a chair. It's, in fact, a little easier on the legs. All you do is cross your legs. So take your left leg, left foot under the right. Cross your right leg over. And if you're able, if you're not, if you've got your shoes on, as Paul has, you don't have to do this. If you want to cross over, just tuck the right foot behind your left ankle. Now, if you don't tuck it in, that's fine. Place it on the side. Inhale. Now, your right leg is over the left thigh. So we're going to get our left elbow over the right elbow. Inhale. Let's bring our arms. Is this in your way, Ginger? Is it okay? Inhale. Bring your arms up to shoulder height, palms facing down. Keep inhaling. Take your arms all the way overhead. Now, this time, you're going to just keep going. As you keep exhaling, bring your left elbow over your right elbow and twine your hands so your palms are clasped in front of your chest. Now remember, you're doing fine. Place your left elbow over your right. That's beautiful. You don't have to twine it. See if you can just make it into a fist. But if you can get your palms together, that's great. And hold it for a while. Now, because your chest seems to be collapsing here, you will feel a wonderful stretch in your trapezius muscles in the back, your latissimus muscles in the back, which is just behind the shoulders, and your deltoids. But because your chest appears to be collapsing, you want to lift your elbow just a little bit and straighten your back. Now hold. When we say hold in this program, it always means hold your posture, not your breath. I cannot stress that enough. Do not ever hold your breath. Exhale and release the arms first, and then release the legs. Now, if your legs sometimes feel like they've gone to sleep, use your hands to release them. You don't want to fall off your chair. You're sitting in your chair at work. Someone very important, or your boss, or somebody comes by, and you don't want them to think, what's happening to this person? She keeps falling off her chair. Place your left foot under, or right behind your right foot under, behind your left ankle. Take your right foot over, your left foot over your right knee. We all knew exactly what I was saying. Even though I said it wrong, we knew that we had to do the other side. So folks at home, sometimes we may make a slip, but just remember, you need to balance both sides of your body. So if you've already crossed the right leg over, this time, take the left leg over. Now, if you want to twine or try to tuck your left foot under your right calf, bring your right foot a little closer and try to tuck it. If it doesn't tuck in, again, as Paul has shoes on, sometimes you may not be able to take your shoes off at work. If you have a desk where your feet are hidden, you could probably do that. And just push your right knee in at an angle, you'll be able to get it. Now, with your feet nice and firm, your left leg is over the right leg. Inhale, take our arms up to shoulder height, palms facing down. Keep inhaling, take your arms all the way overhead. Make a wonderful circle. This time, bring the right elbow over the left elbow. You've got your left knee over, so the right elbow comes over. Now clasp your palms together if you can. If your palms don't clasp today, see if you can just get the back of the palms together. Just make the connection somewhere. You don't want it suspended in midair, because what happens when you keep your palm hands limp, your energy is actually going out. So you want to keep yourself nice and your hands nice and firm. Keep your palms together. Hold. And bring, inhale and bring your chest out. Keep your back nice and straight. Wonderful. Inhale and release your arms first, and then release your legs. In this workout, we got both the legs and the arms to, we got a chance to stretch both of those. Feedback, how did you feel, Tony?
Great.
Just one word. Tony is a man of few words, so that's it. Great. But I'm glad. It felt good, right? Josiane, was your knee a problem at all?
No.
You were okay? Josiane had a tender knee in the last couple of episodes, but she's been very brave. She's come back for more, another yoga addict. And she found a lot of relief, you said, after
yes.
the previous episodes.
So it goes down every time after yoga.
There you go. And in spite of having to cross her knees, she's going to go home and find that knee has gone down. The swelling has gone down. You have to keep coming back, because
yes.
every time you go home, it swells up again. So, Ginger, what did we do? Did you get more or less a feel of a similar kind of benefit as we do in the schools?
Yes, I felt a release just behind the shoulder blades,
right.
which felt really great. Yeah, it's my favorite pose.
Oh, it is. That's good to hear.
Yeah.
Good. Wonderful. You do sit at the desk a lot, right?
Yes, I do that all the time at my desk. Yeah.
There you go. And doing these stretches, I'm sure many of you at home probably do a lot of these stretches. Now you're doing it with an extra awareness. Now you know how it benefits you, and you know it's safe. And as long as you're safe and you're getting some benefit out of it, why not? Jamie, how did
wonderful,
you feel?
Wonderful. I've been swimming a lot lately and doing weights. So this kind of stretching just felt so good for my posture. My back
right.
feels very tight. So
you do a lot of weightlifting.
I have started at the gym.
Wow. You definitely would love our stretches, and you need to stay with us, because folks who work out at the gym a lot probably find this very helpful, because you're strengthening your muscles at the gym.
Yes.
So you want to start stretching them, because that's what the body is about. I'm sure you do your
own
stretches.
I feel so good.
Wonderful. I'm so glad. Khalebo, you're going to stay with us, right? You like it?
Yes.
I'm glad. And you don't feel any pain? You're
no,
okay.
I'm usually very stiff, and training people to use computers is also a very sedentary
right.
job.
Right.
So this is great. I'm thinking, okay, how can I use this?
How
okay,
can I use
great.
It?
This is great. This is great.
Good. Your conference is a great time to start that, right? So you can talk to them about it. Let's go into another posture. It's called Uttan Asan. Uttan is also known in North America as rag doll. Uttan in Sanskrit simply means forward fold. It's a forward suspension. And this time, you're going to have to take your legs apart. In the standing posture, we keep our knees together, heels together, toes apart. But here, because you're going to have to fold forward, keep your feet apart about 6 to 8. Is that 6 to 8? Okay, about 8 inches apart. Just enough for your body to go forward so you can have the lower abdomen pressing on your upper thigh as we go down. And this time, we're not going to clasp our hands. We're going to clasp the opposite elbows. So keep our feet. Actually, you know what? Just to challenge ourselves, let's get a little bit closer because then it becomes too easy and we dive our whole body right through the legs. We don't want to do that. We want to challenge ourselves. Inhale. Bring your arms up to shoulder height, palms facing down. Keep inhaling. Take your arms all the way overhead. This time, instead of clasping your palms together, clasp the opposite elbows. Once you've clasped the opposite elbows, bring your elbows back, which means you'll have to take your shoulders back and then lift your chin. Now, hold this posture for a few seconds while I give you the instructions. We are going to fold forward from the hip, and you're going to exhale. As you go down, keep exhaling and keep your back as straight as you can. Once you go past your knee, try to squeeze between your knees, but you don't have to. You just want to feel the pressure of your lower abdomen on your upper thigh. Exhale and fold. I can see this coming in very useful in an aircraft. As long as the person in front of me doesn't push the chair back. Inhale, come up. Remember, when we come up, tighten your lower abdominal muscles to bring your body up. Keep your back straight. Keep inhaling. Exhale and release. It's just a very gentle forward fold. So you should feel a wonderful compression in the lower abdomen. You should feel a beautiful stretch in your trapezius muscles in the back. And also, I think we're working the triceps by lifting our arms. Let's try this one. This is a little bit complicated sitting in a chair, but I'm sure we can do it. Paul, be careful. Place your right foot in the center of your chair and very gently take your left foot back. Keep your toes curled in. We're going to place the left knee on the floor. Now, if you're short like I am, you're going to fall off your chair. So what we're going to do is, see, if you have a high chair, you want to be careful. You may not want to put your knee on the floor. Keep your toes curled in and very slowly take your toes back as far back as you can. And this time what we're going to do, we're going to take our left elbow and take it over the right knee. So let's first inhale. Inhale, bring your arms up to shoulder height. Make sure your feet are nice and firm on the ground. Keep inhaling, take your arms overhead. Turn your palms in. Now this time you can place your palms together and exhale and bring your left elbow over your right knee. In a standing posture, we do this a little different. We're having a little bit of a variation here. Exhale. If you need to release the right hand and push your right leg in, push your right knee in, do that, and then bring your palm right back over your left palm. And look up to the right at your right elbow. Make sure your left foot, which has its toe, your toes are curled, on the left foot, and if you want to dip your knee to the floor, that's fine. You don't have to. Inhale, come up. Release your arms. Let's change legs. Let's bring the left foot close, or right in the middle of the chair, and then make sure you get a nice, good grip with your right big toe and all the toes on your right foot. Take your right leg all the way back. Curl your toes in. Now inhale, let's bring our arms up to shoulder height, palms facing down. Keep inhaling, turn your palms in. And this time, place your palms together. And this time, we're going to bring the right elbow over the left knee as we exhale. This posture from the standing position is called Parsvakona Namaskara. Paul, be very careful. I know you have your shoes on, so watch out. You should feel a wonderful compression of the midriff. You should feel a beautiful stretch on the right side of your obliques. And look to the left, up at your left elbow. Inhale, let's come back up. And release, bring your right leg back. If folks are not too tired at home, you're still happy to stay with us, we're going to keep going. And Khalebo, at the end of our stretches, we have a couple of questions left for you. Shashank Asan, or rabbit, or hare, as Ginger and Jamie would vouch for this posture, is not easy to do sitting on a chair in exactly the same way as we do sitting on the floor. But today, we're going to try this in a slightly different way. Instead of sitting on our knees and our heels, We're just going to take our feet back just a little bit under your chair. If you have a little bit of a clamp or whatever you call that bar under your chair, tuck your toes over there, somewhere there. Just make sure you get a nice good grip so you don't slip. You don't have that. So those who don't have that, Tony, you have that. So careful. You don't have to put it in the back. Now, if you don't, you don't have to because you have tender knees, so be careful. Just place it there. That's good. Keep your knees together. You got it in. Well done. Keep your knees together. Your feet are together. All we're going to do is just have this beautiful forward fold so you feel a wonderful compression in your lower abdomen again on your upper thigh. Just staying where you are and you'll feel your spine getting a beautiful stretch so your vertebra and everything gets a wonderful relief in the back of your body. Inhale, bring your arms up to shoulder height, palms facing down. Keep inhaling, take your palms overhead. Palms facing in, hands overhead, palms facing in. This time, remember, keep your arms extended. Keep your elbows nice and straight. Your arms are nice and straight. Now I'm going to just tuck my toe, make sure I don't slip. As we exhale, we're going to fold from the hip. Now, depending on how much space you have between your midriff and your thigh, you may want to touch the floor. I'm not quite there. I will one of these days get rid of the man's feel around my waist, and then I should be able to touch the floor. Make sure your arms are nice and straight, though. You just want to feel a beautiful extension in the lower part of your upper arm, your triceps. Inhale, come up. Use your lower abdominal muscles when you come up. Exhale and release. We managed that. Okay. Ardha Matsyendra. The next posture we're going to go into is called Ardha Matsyendra. Ardha is half, as we learned. Matsya is fish. Matsyendra was the name of a sage. And the whole term Ardha Matsyendra simply means half lord of the fishes. This is not the full posture, it's just a half posture. And it's not, the modification we have should probably be a quarter Matsyendra because we are going to do only the upper half. What we're going to do is just cross your right. Now place your left foot firmly in the center of your chair, the center of the front of your chair. Cross your right leg over your left leg. This time you don't have to tuck your right foot behind your ankle. And just push your left knee in just a little bit. All we're going to do is just take, actually no, maybe we should push it this way because we need to take our left elbow over and we're going to turn this way. So inhale, inhale, take the left arm up. As we exhale, we're just going to torque our body a little to the right, and we're going to pretend like there's something on the side, but really we're going to hold on to a chair. At work, you may have your desk over there. You may have another side table. Exhale, bring both your arms to your right. Hold the back of your chair with your right hand and torque your body more to the right. Keep twisting, keep exhaling. The more you exhale, the more air you get out of your body, the more you'll be able to turn. Turn back. Now you can actually turn back and spy on your colleagues behind you, too. Inhale. Let's come back. We have 4 minutes to go. That's wonderful. Thank you, Claudia. Release the leg. This time, place your left leg nice and firm in front of your chair. Take your right leg over your left leg. You do not have to tuck your left leg behind your right ankle or calf. You just place it where it is. And yes, we need to get... Push the left knee in. Inhale. Raise your right arm overhead. Exhale. Take your left hand, place it on the back of your chair. You're already halfway there. Exhale. Bring your right arm by the side of your left hip. Now, if you have something next to you, a little table, you place your palms there. If you just have the back of your chair, hold on to the back of your chair and torque your body to the left. Keep twisting. Keep exhaling. Inhale and release. Whenever we inhale and release, what we're doing is just gently bringing our body back into a normal form. You always want to inhale when you release from a twist like this. You want to fill your body with air so it's easier to move back. Ardha Matsya, Sage Matsyendra would be very proud of us. We did that sitting in a chair. Okay, we have Janu Sirsha. Janu Sirsha simply means Janu is knee, Sirsha is head. All we're going to do, now this is a seated head-to-knee posture, so you can imagine what we're going to do, we're going to raise. If you cannot, if the mountain doesn't come to Muhammad, Muhammad goes to the mountain. So you cannot bring your head to the knee, so we're going to bring the knee to the head. Now, I know, Josie, and you can probably do this very easily, but the rest of us are going to and probably Ginger and Jamie as well. The rest of us are going to still try and keep up. Now, place your right foot firmly on the floor. Inhale and extend the left leg out. Now, this time, you really need to use your lower abdominal muscles. It's very tempting to use your quadriceps, but it's a little hard not to do that this time because you don't have, you're not really sitting on the floor. So on the floor, we just extend the leg. But this time, we're going to try and use the lower abdominal muscles and raise the left leg up. Now, use your hands, hold your leg, and exhale, fold from the hip as much as you can. If your head doesn't touch your knee, that's fine. You just keep, do the best you can any given day. Inhale, lift up, release your leg, and then let's take the other leg up. We probably have another couple of minutes, maybe time for one more posture. Inhale, raise your right leg, extend your right leg out, and then use your hands to push your right leg as high as you can, and then exhale, fold from the hip. Flex your feet, keep your feet flexed. You don't want to point your toes. Keep your feet flexed so you also feel the stretch in the hamstrings. Inhale, come up, release the right leg, and let's relax. I think we have time for one more. Claudia, do we have one more minute? Okay, I think the titles are still there. Let's do one more. And this time we raise both the legs. Now, this time when you raise both your legs again, it's very tempting. Oh, perfect. Raise both our legs, and it's very tempting to use the quad muscles, but we're also going to engage our lower abdominal muscles. Hold on to the edge of your chair. Inhale, lift both your legs in front of you, and then hold with your hands, hold the back of your knees, and just exhale. See if you, it's very hard sometimes not to lower your legs, but see, fold, exhale, and fold from the hip. Just fold forward.
As much as you can is fine. This is a modified version of Paschimottasana. Inhale, come up, and let's release.
Those of you who want to continue to stretch, I have my little commercial. Feel free to continue to stretch. Folks at home, you can watch our program Yoga Express Monday.